welcome to our third FirusTotal Academy for SOC and IR video. FirusTotal gives us results from nearly all antivirus products, as well as many other additional indicators to help us determine whether something is malicious. Let's say we find something suspicious and believe it is indeed malicious. What are those next steps? Not all malware is the same. In this video, we will explore IDs to help you prioritize alerts based on key signals. Let's begin.
Once we determine that a sample looks indeed malicious, we want gaining a basic understanding of its nature. This will help us prioritize the threat. Is the sample potentially able to rapidly distribute within our network? How dangerous is it? Sometimes it is not possible to determine maliciousness or intent from a technical point of view. Still, we want to understand what are its capabilities, its sophistication level, and any external references on the attacker. We can find all of this in FirusTotal. Let's start with the most basic concepts. AV verdicts can provide valuable information about the nature of the attack. Unfortunately, verdicts are not always consistent and cannot be trusted 100% when it comes to providing precise information on the nature of a suspicious sample. Typically, it is better to combine AV verdicts with other factors. But before we move there, let's quickly check some generic malware family categories. Each time we see something that says generic, it means that AV doesn't know what it is, although it appears bad. A PUA, short for potentially unwanted application, is similar. For example, something appears off, and the app might be riddled with spam or ads. There are many categories falling into the category of soft maliciousness, such as clicker, fraud, or even crypto. Let's not go too deep into this and move on to the most dangerous ones. Anything with a ransomware verdict should raise alarms. And it is also important to familiarize yourself with the main ransomware families. A Trojan verdict means potential remote control, basically enabling attackers to interact with the victim's system, installing anything they want. This is a very common verdict. A dropper means the malware is used to drop another malware onto the victim's system. In most cases, a Trojan. It is very usual to have different verdicts categories for any malware sample. Info stealers are dedicated to stealing passwords and cookies from the victim and are one of the most commonly used methods for attackers to gain initial compromise. In this example, crowdsource rules confirm the verdict. Verdicts like Worm and text like Spreader don't tell much about the malware. We just know it will move quickly within our network. Analysts should also become familiar with the main malware families and artifacts used by attackers in different stages. Legitimate tools, such as Midinterpreter or CobbleStrike, are used as part of almost every lateral movement toolset. Their presence in the infrastructure is a strong indicator of an ongoing intrusion. Sandboxes also provide verdicts, usually generic. Being based on what the malware tried to do in the sandbox, these verdicts can be perceived as an excellent addition to the AV ones to determine the nature of the malware. Confirmation from several sources is one of our best allies. FirusTotal includes crowdsource rules that can shed light onto the nature of the malware. Yara uses signatures for malware based on the strings it contains or its geometry. In different words, it is another static detection. However, it's incredibly powerful and became a standard in the industry. Other than Yara, you can find Sigma rules based on the dynamic behavior of a sample when detonated within a sandbox. IDS rules detect suspicious patterns in the traffic generated by the sample, also during sandbox execution. Please notice, Sigma and IDS rules indicate their criticality. Let's see an example. Here, verdicts are not clearly pointing in one direction. However, we find this Yara rule confirming one of them. We can always check the Yara rule itself to confirm if it seems accurate and who created it. We won't always be able to find a perfect alignment between the AVs, sandbox verdicts, and crowdsource rules. What is important is understanding of the nature of all these signals. We will learn different aspects of the sample by combining all of them.
Ultimately, what is important is having high-quality signals that tell us about the different aspects of the malware. Sometimes they will tell the same story, sometimes this is not possible, given that they don't check the same. For instance, it is critical for AVs to be precise and avoid false positives, meaning they tend to err on the side of caution or they even provide generic verdicts when unsure. On the other hand, crowdsourced rules can be more flexible to improve their hunting capabilities. Furthermore, there are also rules dedicated to highly specific malware families or ones that flag suspicious behavior. For the rest of this lesson, let's learn how to recognize some of the most advanced malware families. In terms of alert prioritization, these are the ones where we actually push that red button.
In VirusTotal, there are a few signals and malware samples that might indicate we have something critical in our hands. One of them is an exploit tag. Tags are automatically created by different tools in the VirusTotal ecosystem and can indicate a variety of aspects. When an exploit is detected in any of the antivirus verdicts, this tag is automatically created with the corresponding CVE. The criticality of the exploit plays a major role in determining how an alert should be prioritized. Nevertheless, the fact that a sample attempts to exploit something is a good indicator for a first stager or dropper trying to install additional malware. There are special cases where we face malware linked to a specific threat actor. We can recognize these samples in different ways. Including exploit crowdsource rules, detailed comments, malware belonging to attributed collections, or even specific malware families. To familiarize ourselves with threat actors and related malware families, Mitre is a great source of information. Let's see an example. We see the following sample belongs to a collection that appears linked to a particular actor. Our suggestion is to always check the source to confirm the true nature of the sample itself. Belonging to a collection does not necessarily mean it is linked to a particular actor. In this case, we can see that even when this file appeared as an IOC part of an investigation, it is a legitimate file. Indeed, nowadays attackers include many generic malware families in their arsenal. This helps them avoid attribution. Families such as MetaBreeder or CobbleStrike are used by almost every single threat actor. If the malware we started investigating turns out to be a highly suspicious one, like clearly attributed to a well-known threat actor, it means we are ready to escalate the incident. There are different courses of action, including checking if we find any related IOCs in our CM, deploying Yara rules in our EDRs, or checking what are the TTPs associated with the actor.